안녕하세요. 자, 지금 우리 할 문법은 noun plus 때문에. 자, 때문에 you probably have heard it a lot that is used quite often. So 우리 바로 봅시다. 때문에 is used after a noun to express the meaning because of. 네. 자, 우리 예문을 봐요. 때문에 친구를 만나지 못했습니다. Because of something. 네, the something is not here. Because of something, I wasn't able to meet my friends. So, because of studying for exams. 자, 여러분, studying for exams 뭐예요? 네, 생각해 보세요. That before I tell you the answer, try to figure out the answer yourself. So, exams 뭐예요? 시험. 저 시험 공부 때문에 친구를 만나지 못했습니다. So, because of exam, I couldn't meet my friends. 자, 다른 예문을 봐요. Because of something. 외출을 잘안 해요. 외출을 뭐예요? 외출? 자, because of COVID, I don't go out often. So, 여기 COVID 한국말로 뭐예요? 혹시 아세요? 이거 코로나. So, 코로나 때문에 외출을 안 해요. So, this grammar is pretty straightforward. You just need to put a noun in front of 때문에. So because of something, something else is happening or something else is not happening. 네. So 여기 take notes가 있어요. 자, 여기 take notes는 뭐예요? Compared to the 아서, 어서, 어니까 때문에 emphasizes the reason more definitely. So 시험 공부 때문에. So this one, the reason, 시험 공부. It's more definite when you use the 때문에. And it is also often used in formal speech or writing. So 때문에 compared to 아서 애니까 is used more in formal speech and in writing. 괜찮죠? Of course, when you speak, you can also use the 때문에. 네. But in writing, 때문에 is used more. 지금 우리 FAQ 봅시다. 1번, when is 때문에 not used? 그리고 2번, difference between 이기 때문에 and 때문에? 3번, is 때문에 only used in negative sentences? 자, FAQ 1 바로 봐요. 자, 여기 때문에, when is it not used? You cannot use it with an imperative or propositive sentence. What is this? So, propositive sentence is something that's used a lot in Korean language grammar. So, propositive sentence is essentially suggestion, and imperative is like command. So, 우리 여기 예문을 봐요. 감기 때문에 병원에 갔어요. 감기 때문에 병원에 갔어요. 감기 때문에 병원에 갈까요? 자, out of these three sentences, only one of them is correct. So the other two are incorrect. So which are the two incorrect sentences? Think about it before I give the answer. 네. 자, 이거 맞아요. 감기 때문에 병원에 갔어요. So this is correct. However, for the other two sentences, they are wrong because 가세요 is an imperative sentence. Imperative meaning it is a command. So because of a flu, you go to the hospital. So 이거 안 돼요. You cannot use 때문에. 감기 때문에 병원에 갈까요? 갈까요는 이거 suggestion이에요. Shall we go to the hospital? 이거는 you cannot use 때문에. 네. So if it is a imperative, meaning like a command, 가세요. Please go. You go. You cannot use 때문에. 네. Propositive, suggestion, 갈까요? Shall we do this? 이거 also cannot use 때문에. In this case, 니까 should be used. 네, 니까. 네, 감기 이니까 감기니까 병원에 가세요. 감기니까 병원에 갈까요? 자, 다음에 여기 FAQ 2 봅시다. 자, FAQ 2는 뭐예요? Difference between 이기 때문에 and 때문에. 자, 이게 뭐예요? 우리 예문을 봐요. 친구 때문에 갔어요. 친구 이기 때문에 갔어요. So, what are the meanings for these two sentences? They are not the same. So 생각해 보세요. So 여기 친구 때문에 because of friend I went. 친구이기 때문에 because you are my friend. So 이것은 너무 비슷해요. Too similar in these two sentences. 맞아요? So this one because of friend. That's why I went. That. So my friends are in a party, so I also want to go to the I want to go to the party too. So I went because of my friends. 친구 있기 때문에 갔어요. Because you are my friend and you are asking me to go, I will go. So it's different. 네. So the second sentence 친구 있기 때문에 you can interpret it like this. Essentially, it is 친구예요. 그래서 갔어요. Because you are my friend. Because it is a friend, because she's a friend and she's asking me to go, so I went because she's my friend. If she's not my friend, I wouldn't listen to her. This is what it means. So 친구이기 때문에 갔어요 하고 친구라서 갔어요. It's kind of the same meaning. 네. To make a more clearer comparison, 우리 다른 예문을 봅시다. So, B 때문에 늦었어요. B이기 때문에 늦었어요. 자, one of the sentences is a little funny. So which one? Because of rain, I was late. Because it is the rain, I was late. So 어떤 거? 틀려요? So 이거 이상해요. 네. So 비 때문에, because of the rain. Because of the rain, I was late. Because it is the rain. No, this doesn't make sense. So 이거 안 돼요. So 네, 비 때문에는 하고 비이기 때문에, 이기 때문에 비예요. 그래서 늦었어요. 이상해. 오케이? 자, 지금 FAQ상 봅시다. 자, 여기 이 때문에 only use the negative sentences. 비 때문에 늦었어요. 비 때문에 한국 노래를 들어요. 비 덕분에 날씨가 시원해졌어요. 자, all the sentences are correct. Because some students often hear 때문에 in negative sentences, so you might think that 때문에 is only used in negative sentences. No, 때문에 can be used in all kinds of sentences. But it is used more in negative sentences because 때문에, remember, it's used when the reason is more definite. So usually in a negative situation, you want to emphasize the reason more, which is why 때문에 is probably used more in negative sentences. So, 여기 비 때문에 늦었어요 is a negative situation. 비 때문에 한국 노래 들어요. This is just a simple reason. It's neutral. 자, 비 덕분에. 자, 덕분에 is not 때문에. 자, 덕분에는 is also because, but it is only used in positive sentences. So, thanks to the rain, the weather turned cold. Cool. 네. So, 비 덕분에. So, in this case, thanks to. And it's not like English, right? Oh, thanks to the rain. I was late. No. So, in this case, there's no such connotations. So, it's really just 비 덕분에. So, thanks to the rain, the weather turned cool. And it's a positive situation. So, you have to use 덕분에. 자, so, to summarize, 때문에 does not carry a negative tone. It can be used in any kind of sentences. 네. However, it is true that 때문에 is used more in negative sentences. 네. Because probably you want to emphasize the reason more, so that's why in negative situations, so you use 때문에 more in negative sentences. 자, in contrast, 덕분에 is only used in positive sentences. 네. So it is like thanks to something. 네? 좋아요. 지금 우리 연습 합시다. So translate the sentences. Because of the boss, I get stressed out. Because of age, I cannot drink alcohol. Because this is good food, I eat every day. One of them is using 이기 때문에, so 주의하세요. 네. Pause the video, 써보세요. Try. 네. Before I give you the hint. Pause the video because the hint is coming up. 여기 사장님, 스트레스 받다. 나이, 술을 마시다. 좋은 음식, 매일 먹다. 자, 비디오를 멈추시고요. 네, 써보세요. Try to write the answers before I give you the answer, which is coming right now. 사장님 때문에 스트레스를 받아요. 나이 때문에 술을 못 마셔요. 이것은 좋은 음식이기 때문에 because this is good food. That's why I eat it every day. 네. So, 여기까지입니다. Noun plus 때문에. 감사합니다.